Hi guys, and welcome back to the channel. So this is a long overdue video about interfacing a USB low-speed keyboard with your FPGA. So I use this core, which is available on GitHub. It's not written by me, it's written by someone else, some other guys, which I have to thank you for their work and for sharing with us. So I use this core as it is from GitHub repository. I'm going to put a link in the description. Is it written in Verilog? It's very well written and it's very clearly explained with very good explanations in the code. It worked out of the box. I only need to make a tiny little modification in one file, which I'm going to document. So yeah, I'm not going to talk too much in the intro about this. It's a simple way to interface a cheap keyboard to your design. And I use this in my Sinclair Spectrum project. I had to write a small decoder to present the data, the decoded keys in a certain way, but that's out of the scope of this video. So yeah, I'm going to show you the code, the structure, not much, only a few files, and then a short demo at the end. So I hope you'll enjoy the video, and yeah, let me know in the comments. Okay, very quick, the file structure. It's not much here, so there are only three files here in the project. Now, only one is of interest, which is what is coming from GitHub, so which is the keyboard USB HID host.v. This is the name of the file. And below that is actually a ROM file implementation. So I'm going to show them here on the screen. I'm just going to double click. So this is the Verilog file, which comes from GitHub. And this is the GitHub path here. I'm not sure if it's very visible. the main interface here is actually split in three interfaces. One is the keyboard interface, where the data is presented how it comes from the keyboard, in the case of a keyboard. Then it's a mouse interface. Actually, the core can decode the mouse information. And then is the gamepad. So it's actually, I would say there are three cores in one, right? Now the output of the keyboard actually, it's split in more than one byte. It's a key modifier. And then there are three or actually four interfaces. Why four? This is not like the PS2 keyboard. The PS2 keyboard, they just give you a scan code. So you press a key and it just gives you that key. The USB keyboard, they're actually more clever. They can present you multiple codes. So you can have multiple presses and it gives you all those codes. It's very good for gaming. I mean, this is a step up for gaming. So it's actually presenting you multiple keystrokes simultaneously over those interfaces. Now, how do you know from which interface to read? You have actually here a type output, which is telling you, okay, this is a keypad, this is a gamepad, or whatever. Now, I wrote a wrapper around this in VHDL because my design was VHDL, but the relevant files are this V file, and there is another file here, just going to expand. It's a ROM file, below this. It's a ROM file, which is just a memory with some code, which is executed by a small microcontroller, which is implemented in the core. Now, I had to modify one line here. I think I added here 0:536 instead of just 536. I'll document the modification that you have to do. Maybe they already corrected this. Anyway, so there is another file here, referenced here, which is the content of this memory, like a ROM file. So that's pretty much it. There are basically three files. The main file, which implements all the controls, and then is the memory, and then is the content of the memory. That's pretty much it. Now, the rest of what I have here, I'm just going to collapse this. I put a decoder. I wrote a decoder, so I have to present the data in a certain format for my Sinclair Spectrum project. So it's a decoder which actually decodes individual keys in individual signals. Not much. And here is another one where I'm creating the 12 megahertz clock for the core. So you need to have 12 megahertz available, or to make that if you have a PLL block in your FPGA. So you need to provide 12 megahertz. That's in a nutshell. I'll go straight to demo. Just keep it short. Okay, a quick demo. The hardware setup first. So I'm supplying 5 volt to the keypad directly, to the keyboard directly, because I didn't have available 5 volt available on those external connectors. The data lines from the keyboard, they have some 2 pull down resistor 15 kilo ohms, and 2 series resistors 220 ohms going straight into the FPGA pins. So I put those resistors just to make sure I'm not damaging the pin. Now, you can buy a PMOD board, which is available on the internet, which has the connectors, the resistors, and it has a tiny little boost converter, which makes 5 volt out of 3.3, which is very useful. So if you don't want to use an external power supply, or you want to integrate it into your design. Now, I mapped LEDs on the board. There are some LEDs. I mapped up some keys on the keypad to make sure it works, to test the design. So the keys of interest are Control, Alt, and Shift on both sides of the keypad. So I'm pressing Shift on one side, Shift on the other side, Control on one side, Control on the other, Alt, and Alt. So I added a decoder to decode the exact keys, because the core gives you everything in byte format, but it's very easy to decode. So the only reason I added a decoder is for my Sinclair Spectrum project. So that's kind of belongs to that project. Otherwise, it works out of the box. So it's Verilog. I wrote a VHDL wrapper because my main design was VHDL. But I only had to make a tiny little modification on one Verilog line to make it work in Vivado, but it's not a big deal. I'm going to document that. So thank you very much for the core. I know people, they've been working hard for this. And thank you for sharing with us, with the rest of the world. And I hope you enjoyed the demo.